英雄，也是忧郁情人，还可以是
I like him. Oh, is that bad?
化身导演，他嗨翻全场。
Power control. Ah, that's what I want.
You're really hot.
Oh my god.
Like
oh my
god.
I'm not a sex symbol.
也首次披露不为人知的悲伤过往。
Do you feel helpless?
I don't think grief goes completely away.
杨澜专访基努·里维斯，让他来
Deal Soul
正在播出，敬请收看。
大家好，欢迎收看杨澜访谈录，本节目是由华晨汽车独家冠名赞助播映的。看过《生死时速》《黑客帝国》的观众一定不会忘记基努·里维斯俊美的外表和矫健的身手，一个几乎完美的英雄甚至是超人的形象，这也使得日后呢，他在任何公众场合出现，或胖或瘦都会引起人们的一阵热议。基努·里维斯来到了中国，我们知道基努这个词呢，在夏威夷土语中是吹过山头的清风的这样的一个意思，那么按照我们中国人的话来说，是哪一阵风把他吹到了中国呢？原来是他带着自己导演的处女作太极侠来到了这里。无论是一部片子的名字，他的主演，还是他主要的拍摄场地，都和中国有着不解之缘。让我们掌声有请基努·里维斯 Ladies and gentlemen, Keanu Reeves。
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Come on! I got you!
从生死时速中身手矫健拯救众人的英俊警察，到云中漫步中木讷深情的退伍军人，再到黑客帝国里那个一袭黑色风衣高傲孤独的救世主，毫无疑问，基努·里维斯是中国人最喜爱的好莱坞明星之一。尽管远离主流观众视线颇有些时日，基努却在今年强势回归，而他的角色也悄悄发生了变化。一个依旧英俊潇洒的荧幕偶像，一个走出了中年危机的成熟男人，一个勾引人心走向毁灭的大反派，以及一个混迹中国片场的大导演。今年七月，由他首次执导的电影《太极侠》将在全球上映。
First of all, this is a movie, the first movie that I have ever directed. Are you nervous?
Am I nervous? I'm nervous, excited.
How is it different from those movies you actually starred in?
Well, I didn't direct them.
Yeah, so, because this is your baby, right?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's a bigger feeling. I've worked on the script, you know, developing the story for so many years. Mm. You know, when you're acting, you're just a part of something in this. Yeah.As a director, you're kind of responsible
for the whole thing.
For the whole thing. So it's, if you love it, I'm part of it. Mm. And if you don't like it, it's my fault.
Okay, that's fair. So first of all, what's the story about?
这部电影以现代北京为背景，讲述了一个名叫陈虎的快递员，同时也是一个太极高手。他被基努·里维斯所扮演的地下黑拳犯罪组织首脑所引诱，进入地下格斗俱乐部。随着力量的增长，他内心残暴的一面开始显现出来。
这不是什么武术比赛，是杀人游戏。
His master is telling him to meditate, to think about the choices that he's making, but he's feeling the power, and so he loses himself.
Wow.
But through this journey, he finds himself, hence the Tai Chi.
You have got the opportunity to play a villain in this movie, the first one in all the characters you have played.
Donica.
How do you dig out the dark side of yourself?
Oh, that's, we all have a dark side.
Of course. Yeah. Do you want to have a look at this Donica character? We have it.
You're not a warrior. You're a rat.
You know who you are, Tiger. You know what you are. Killer be killed, Tiger. That's what they want. That's what I want.
That's terrifying. What does it feel, you know, look at yourself and you like him?
I like him. Oh, is that bad?
It's very bad, actually.
The character that I play, I think, is like Mephistopheles. He's a seducer. He's interested in power.
How would you like to test how good you are, Tony? No referees, no rules. Pure fighting, random. But to watch a person's life evolve and change, that is what I offer.
I enjoyed the idea of being that manipulator, someone, you know, who is, wants control.
Wow. Okay.
Steal a soul.
Wow. Yeah. How
Take
vicious.
A life.
Let's hear from the audience whether they have any comments or questions, okay?
Okay.
Hi. I have to say, we all think you're really hot on the movie, but now you're just sitting here. I think you're even more hot.
Oh my gosh.
How do you like being called hot?
It's a compliment.
No, thank you very much.
What is your ambitions? So is the same as the dark guy in the movie and want the power and want to control everything? Something like that.
You know what's interesting? I think this is what I found, like playing the bad guy. It's like the animal side. It's like the animal. Like,
because you don't have other opportunities to let that part of you out.
No, you get to just, yeah, you can just be like, arr, arr.
As a wolf man.
Yeah, you know, it's like power, control, ha, ha, that's what I want. You know, and there's something about that feels good.
Well, just as the lady said, you know, you are adored by many people. Permit me to say that, like a sex symbol or handsome or a hot man. How do you like that? How do you hate that? I rejected it. But they also care about whether you have gained a few pounds in the recent picture,
right,
or this or that. Yeah, you don't like that, do you? You know, people are so sensitive about, you know, how much weight you have, and do you want to, you know, brass it out and say it's none of your business? You know,
it's life. I don't know.
It's life.
I don't know.
You can't control people's perspectives, the comment, no. But you don't like that, as
Take
you said.
His camera.
They just love you. How can you help with that, right?
Yeah.
这是《黑客帝国》里的一幕，那个戴着黑墨镜、长着东方面孔的反派，你是否觉得眼熟？没错，他正是《太极侠》一片的男主角陈虎。当年拍摄《黑客帝国》时，陈虎正是武术指导袁和平派给基努·里维斯的武术教练。通过五个月的集训，二人成为好兄弟。而这部电影正是基努·里维斯对陈虎的承诺，要将他的故事搬上大荧幕。然而，要实现这一承诺谈何容易？该片从构思到最终拍摄完成，整整花费5年时间。为了拍片，他不仅要长期驻扎中国，还要承受票房的压力，马不停蹄，四处跑通告，以至于他在戛纳出现时身形的变化，也被人认为是影片后期工作繁重造成的压力肥。然而，基努·里维斯却似乎乐在其中，他爱上了川菜，喝白酒可以灌倒一大票人。在片场，大家都亲切地称呼他为老李。在他的导演专用座椅上，也用中文楷书标注着“老李”字样。
You have earned the nickname Lao Li at the shooting field here in China, right? Do you like that?
Yeah, sure. It's
Lao Li. Shooting a film actually in China is working in unfamiliar circumstances. There are things beyond your control that you cannot ask for, and frustrations and all sorts of things like that. Did you lose your temper once?
Did I lose my temper?
Quite a few times.
No.
No?
No.
Not as I heard. Let's hear about what Tiger Chen has to say about you.
训练他的时候，生气的时候就，他反正就练，不高兴就大吼一声啊，然后就走了，转身就走了，他就跟你说。你也刚开始你对他不熟悉嘛，你也不知道啊，我怎么了啊，我做什么，我就把他惹火了，我就转身就走了，然后我就在那儿等，反正一般就是等个差不多十几分钟吧，他就回来了，然后他就情绪就调整过来了，又回来了，又继续练，然后多几次以后呢，你就懂了，你就知道了，哦，可能觉得自己练得不好，心里比较毛躁，就自己去调整一下情绪再回来，然后他只要再发火我也就走了，我也就去喝咖啡了。我就看着点儿，差不多10分钟、15分钟啊，我就回去了。他也就过来了，就继续练。
Since your Chinese is so good, what's your comment on that?
well said.
Well said.
When you want to get it right, especially if it's a physical action for me, what happens is your qi gets blocked. And so I have to let it out so that I can come back. The yell is like, say, so if we're doing something and I mess it up or it's not very good, then I'll go away and I'll like, nah. And then that lets me flow.
Okay.
And then I'm back and then I can flow.
Yeah.
流动、阴阳、太极、平衡。如今的基努·里维斯张口闭口都是东方武术的专有名词，几乎要让人忘记他曾是好莱坞的英雄专业户。大荧幕上从来不缺少武艺高强拯救世界的英雄形象，而从小看武侠片长大的中国观众对此有着更多样化的选择以及更加挑剔的眼光。
佛山黄飞鸿，
一边是黄飞鸿霍元甲，另一边是超人钢铁侠，到底谁是你心目中的英雄？游走于东西方文化之间，基努·里维斯对于东西方英雄又有着怎样的理解呢？
We have seen so many superheroes, in you know whatever Batman, Spider-Man, Iron Man, and all sorts of superhero type, and then you have touched the basis of Chinese kung fu masters, you know, Xia. How do you interpret the differences between these cultures?
When you speak about like Superman or Batman, they have a duality to them, right? Mm. They have like one personality that's in the world, and then they have this heroic or other side to them.
They have to cover their true self to be a hero.
Yeah, they have to hide in a way.
Well, honey, I'm sure you can find a way to interview Superman without bringing him back into your life.
There's really no way around it, folks. Superman is back in all of our lives. We're coming to you from downtown Sydney, where people have gathered on this rooftop to...
Sometimes you have people, you know, in Eastern kung fu movies or something that they're undercover in the sense that I'm just a humble person or I'm the old guy or, you know, I don't look. And then, you know, or then comes, you know.
How about some of the more spiritual aspect?
Yeah, I mean, I think if we're talking about Superman or Batman, there's not necessarily, I mean, they're generally...activated, right? They have to do something physical. They have to stop the train. They have to stop the bomb.
Overcome the evil.
Yeah. And there's not so much of what, but then they'll do what's the personal cost on that? How do you lose your personal life? Or what's the responsibility of power? And there's never an answer for that.
But the Chinese kung fu masters always have something very wise to say at the end of it.
Yes. Yeah,
even the panda have something wise to say.
Yeah.
How did you find peace? I took away your parents.Everything. I scarred you for life.
See, that's the thing, Shen. Scars heal.
No, they don't. Wounds heal.
Oh, yeah. What do scars do? They fade, I guess?
I don't care what scars do.
You should, Shen. You gotta let go of that stuff from the past, because it just doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is what you choose to be now.
And that's what I was trying to do in this piece. In Tai Chi Sha, Tiger is like, well, power can solve, it can be the solution. And the master's like, that's an illusion. You know, if you go forward with this path without meditation, it will lead to destruction.
Well, as Sun Tzu said, actually, not fighting is the ultimate goal of fighting, basically. That's something philosophical about that.
Yes.
其实严格意义上他对这个美国的侠呢他还不是特别的喜欢因为他自己是一个比较走内心的一个人所以他更喜欢内在更丰富的东西所以他觉得可能东方的侠他会更喜欢一些
正如陈虎所说基努·里维斯似乎更像是东方的侠外表放浪不羁却注重与自己内心的对话尽管江湖排名颇高但却游离于体制内外视金钱与名利于无物他热爱音乐可以放弃5000万的片酬带着自己的乐队进行长达8个月的全球音乐巡演即使在黑客帝国让他大红大紫之时他也没有一位接拍片酬很高的大片 而钟情于自己喜欢的小成本的独立电影。为了感谢黑客帝国里的替身演员，他还自掏腰包买了12辆哈雷机车作为礼物。这件事让他此后好久都笑得特别开心，梦里都笑出声来。
You have given twelve Harleys as gifts to your stunt team for the Matrix, right?
Oh yes, yes.
And they were overwhelmed by that. How many people have broken their ribs? It's my question.
You know, they're still all okay.
Okay, that's good to hear.
No, that was a wonderful day.
Why do you want to do that?
Yeah, I was just saying thank you.
Uh huh. And they still come back and say thank you?
Yeah, I don't know. I see him a couple of times. I mean, we shared something, you know, and I had the opportunity to be able to do that, which I'm very grateful for.
自掏腰包这件事情并不是基努·里维斯头一回干。1997年，为了让奥斯卡影帝阿尔·帕西诺能在《魔鬼代言人》中演出，他提出自降身价$1,000,000，以补贴前者高昂的片酬。在这部电影中，基努扮演了一个在欲望和良知中挣扎的年轻律师，和帕西诺大飙演技，突破了自己以往的角色限制。
She's got to come first. You know what scares me? I quit the case. She gets better, and I hate her for it.
然而，由于内容过于非主流，在《魔鬼代言人》之后，整整一年，基努·里维斯都没有接到任何片约，但他仍然将此片看作自己最得意的作品之一。
Actually, you offered to reduce your own payment.
How do you know that?
Everybody, they told me.
Oh, that doesn't matter. I remember the time that I heard that Al Pacino was going to do it, my blood got cold. You know, I was like, oh my God, I'm going to get to act with
Al Pacino. He actually agrees to do that.
Yeah, no, that I was going to get a chance to act with him.
But money doesn't seem to be the ultimate goal of your career, right?
No, I don't think you can go into acting and think that, like, I'm going to make a lot of money acting.
A lot of people do enter this career expecting that.
Good luck.
Good luck. But actually, it's not the case. For most of working actors, it's not the case.
No, it's not.
然而，如大多数英雄的成长经历那样，基努·里维斯的身世也颇为颠沛流离。1964年，基努出生于黎巴嫩首都贝鲁特，父亲是个地质学家，拥有一半中国血统。在他2岁时，父母离异。母亲带着他和妹妹吉姆辗转在澳洲和纽约，最后定居加拿大多伦多。期间母亲又结过4次婚，不过每次婚姻都以草草离异收场。家庭生活的不幸再加上不断迁居，小时候的基努·里维斯是一个十足的问题少年。在高中的时候，他总共受到了4个学校的退学处分。
Because we're talking about a journey of a man, you know, from boy to manhood, basically. You have experienced a very turbulent kind of childhood by traveling so extensively across the world.
Yeah.
In a lot of instability in your life. Is there a sense of insecurity in your character as you see it?
On the one hand, yes. And on the other hand, you know, whether it's compensatory or maybe because I've had to deal with an independence for a long time.
Yeah, at a very early age.
Yeah, so you have this kind of combination of perhaps insecurity, but then also confidence because you've had to survive or you've, you know, I've always been a very self-motivated person. So, you know, those two things are, it's very Tai Chi. They're both
Tai Chi.
It's very existing at the same thoughts. No, because you're having confidence and then you're also having insecurity, but then, and sometimes they exist and sometimes they don't exist. And sometimes the insecurity leads you to becoming more independent. And then once you are more independent, then will it last?
问题少年基努·里维斯却从表演当中寻找到了乐趣以及精神寄托。17岁时，他结束学校生活，决心走上演艺之路。
I think it probably started with my day, my life, you know, being a young person. I felt like I had, if it wasn't a calling,it was something that, you know, when I would act in school, you know, when I would do stuff in community theater, it felt like home.
Was there anyone saying to you that, Keanu, you have no future in this, stop
you
this?
You suck.
Was there anyone who tried to persuade you out of this?
In the acting? No.
No.
I remember I had a principal in school. He wasn't my biggest fan, but, you know, I remember him kind of saying, you're going to be, blah, it's going to be, ah.
you would become what? What did he say?
I think he was trying to inspire me by telling me how bad my life can be if I didn't get it together.
Okay.
So I got it together.
You got it together. In retrospect, how do you think those different cultural backgrounds may benefit you?
I think that probably ties into the independence again. You're not afraid as much, maybe. And maybe that created some of the desire that, you know, you're kind of speaking about to the gypsy aspect.
Gypsy aspect.
Yeah, the gypsy aspect, you know, that I'm comfortable, that's familiar to me, to go to the new place.
生死时速，黑客帝国，全球引发激怒狂潮。荧幕上他能拯救世人，荧幕下他却失去挚爱。
Neo, the character in Matrix, he had the superpower to give his beloved ones rebirth. But in your real life, you have experienced some losses of the closest people around you.
It's not comfort like ice cream.
下节请继续收看杨澜专访基努·里维斯《大侠老李》。22岁那年，基努·里维斯开着自己买的第一辆车，一辆1969年产的二手沃尔沃，向着世界电影中心的好莱坞出发了。在继父的安排下，他先后在一系列青少年电影和小成本文艺电影中获得演出机会，并逐渐崭露头角。1994年，基努·里维斯的电影生涯迎来重大转折，凭借在《生死时速》扮演的那个年轻帅气、充满正义感的警察，他首次进入好莱坞一线明星之列。而这对他而言仅仅是一个开始。5年后，《黑客帝国》上映，基努·里维斯在电影中所塑造的黑客形象神秘、冷酷、充满力量，在全世界引发了崇拜和模仿的狂潮。随着电影票房在全球步步升高，基努的声势也被推到了顶点。
The Matrix films changed my life.
In what ways?
That's like having the chance to climb the mountain. That experience of having to love something so much and to have the opportunity to try and do the best work that you can for years. I can't forget something like that.
有人这样凭借他演的尼奥，虽然电影中的武打和特技令人眼花缭乱，演员们也一律黑衣墨镜，酷劲十足，但仍然掩盖不住基努·里维斯的锋芒。尼奥的天赋异禀和高超的功夫无疑是他成功的必要条件，然而信念、希望和爱，这些最软弱也最伟大的特质，才是人类生生不息的奥秘所在。基努·里维斯并没有刻意掩饰人类的软弱和彷徨，而是用他的含蓄忧郁给英雄增添了一股悲情。勇敢、脆弱、冷酷、深情、强大、敏感，基努·里维斯给予角色的复杂而透彻的诠释，不仅仅来自于天赋，更来自于他的人生经历。
What is it like to play a role, a solitude? I think, you know, those heroes, because they have no other people to turn to solve the problems they face.
See, there's the independence. But you can't, you're never alone. You always need to have.
Yeah. You grew up without a father, real father around you.
But that's true.
Is there a kind of hole in the growing up process? Do you feel that's a...
Yeah, of course. When I think about that boy, you know, I think, you know, there's so much that, you know, you want to see your father. I can remember, you know, wanting to be with him and be around him and all of those things. So when that doesn't happen, you know, of course.
And what did you do if you couldn't find him around?
Well, you know, I'm a child, you know, in those things you can only feel. You have no control over your environment.
而失去对于基努·里维斯而言，似乎是人生中挥之不去的阴影。这位非典型好莱坞巨星在现实人生中见证的生离死别非常人所能想象。他最深爱的妹妹吉姆患有白血病，长久以来吉姆都伴他左右，为他支付巨额的医疗费。1993年，曾经与他合作《不羁的天空》的好友菲尼克斯因为吸毒身亡，而在《黑客帝国》大卖之时，厄运也接踵而来。先是他和女友尚未出世的孩子胎死腹中，接着女友也因为车祸意外死亡。 在电影中，他总能拯救世界，拯救所爱之人，而在现实当中，他又如何去面对种种失去呢？
Neo, the character in Matrix, he had this superpower to give his beloved ones rebirth. But in your real life, you have experienced some losses of the closest people around you.
Yes.
How has that changed your perspective of life? And in those most difficult times, what brought you comfort?
Grief is, and the loss of a loved one is horrible. I don't think grief goes completely away. And I think grief, though, can become supported by love and the memory, you know, and how we can cherish who we've lost and how we remember them. And then perhaps, you know, with the friends that we knew with them or the family, with, you know, whatever the circumstances that the loss can
bring. Did you feel helpless and vulnerable?
Yeah, of course. You know, you miss them. You want them to be here, you know.
What gave you comfort?
Comfort, you know, comes from, you know, your friends. It comes through your memory. And, you know, that, you know, the respecting and feeling the time that you did have with them. You know, I think it's a grief comfort.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think it's, you know, it's not comfort like ice cream.
No, of course, no.
But it's, and I guess then that's just respecting and appreciating, you know, whoever that person was and is, you know, try not to be afraid.
Kiss me.
With how we live and all of our experiences, I think we bring in our best selves, you know, we bring that to the table.
Yeah.
You know, and especially in the creative act, you know, that's your foundation, that's your well, that's your fuel. You know, what have you lived? What do you hope for? What have you experienced?
And actually, people are very smart to see whether that act is authentic or not. You know, it's if it's not something from the real heart, people will tell.
俗话说，四十不惑，他却陷入孤独的丝质睡裤。
And then you start thinking about death.
You seem to have got everything that millions of people dreamed about. What could have get you lost?
Yeah.
I knew that you broke a few ribs for that.
The wind in your hair, you're traveling, the sound, the smell.
下节请继续收看杨澜专访基努·里维斯，大侠老李，四十而不惑。然而，基努·里维斯的四十岁却经历了一段自我反省的消沉期。2011年，他出版了自己的诗集，虽然名为《快乐赋》，却全篇尽是悲伤的独白。我画下悲伤的热洗澡水，在我绝望的房间里，再次陷入孤独的丝质睡裤。
You said you have passed your midlife crisis. What was the crisis?
Oh gosh, you know, sometimes it happens. You turn 40, and then you start thinking about death and the past and the present, and you get a little depressed and crazy, and you cry a little bit, and then it's over.
You seem to have got everything that millions of people dreamed about. What could have get you lost?
You know, I think when you first have those experiences where you get recognized, some of them are really great.
Yeah.
And then I think there's sometimes an adjustment where, you know, your private life stops being so private.
So far, what has been the biggest challenge in your career then?
The biggest challenge in my career.
Yeah, how to go beyond Matrix.
I don't know if you can ever go beyond Matrix, but you can do other things, and you can maybe make a Chinese Kung Fu movie, you know?
To do something different.
Yeah.
What
and
are
to keep exploring and to, for me, it's, you know, the challenge is to keep having a career, you know, to be able to have the opportunity to tell stories and be part of telling stories.
Do you still love motorcycling that much?
Yeah.
I knew that you broke a few ribs for that.
Oh, motorcycling, yes. Yes. Well, I maybe have.
Are you becoming older and wiser than riding the motorcycle without headlights?
Oh, nice. Once in a while. But yeah, absolutely. As you get more experienced, you get more experienced.
So that's the wilder side of Keanu Reeves.
I don't know if it's wilder. I don't know. Maybe it's like going into nature. But the going machine, into it's the like nature. A, yeah, like the wind in your hair, you're traveling, the sound, the smell.
走过动荡的童年，经历过失去爱人的痛苦，走出为死亡而焦虑的中年危机。如今的基姆·里维斯最爱说的一句话，就是自己变老了，但却变智慧了。你可能会说，他早已过了演艺的巅峰期，太极侠或许并不如想象的精彩，然而电影对他而言早已超越了所谓的名与利。拍电影可能是为了一个故事，也可能是为了一个承诺，只是不知道下一刻这个剃去了胡茬的男人会骑着自己的机车去往哪个地方。
好，非常感谢基努·里维斯呢来到我们的演播室，的确让我们觉得这里也吹过了一股清新的风，是不是这样？感谢他带来非常真实又非常这个顽皮的一面。其实在他的这个身上，我们依然可以看到那个热爱流浪的小男孩的身影。也许正像他希望通过电影《太极侠》告诉我们的那样，这个世界变化实在太快了，有太多的诱惑，有太多的困难在等待着我们。但是这个时候我们能做的就是守护好我们自己的内心，理解我们是谁，我们究竟要做什么。也再次感谢基努·里维斯来到我们的现场，也感谢我们的战略合作伙伴罗丽芬美容集团的大力支持。我们下周见。 Thank you, Keanu.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Great pleasure.